Derek Englund joining us here on the Rich Eisen Show. How are you, Derek?
How's it going?
I'm fine. How does your hearing your words back all these months later, now knowing that you're a step away from playing for the Stanley Cup potentially, how do those words hit you now, Derek?
Still tough to know, you know. It just brings back memories of when I was told. But at the same time, it's, you know, it's something for myself to be proud to get up and be able to speak those words to all the people that were there and the people that were listening. And, you know, it was just an honor to be able to do that.
And again, you go back, you're originally from Canada, but you go back to Vegas with your Las Vegas Wranglers days in the ECHL well over 10 years ago, correct?
Yeah. I've been basically living in Vegas since those days, since 03, so about 15 years.
And now, just again, the fact that this team has done what it has done, I guess a simple question is, how have you been able to do what you've done, Derek?
Oh, I think, first off, they did a tremendous job with the expansion draft and, you know, deals and stuff like that. But then after that, it's every guy coming in, you know, kind of coming together extremely quickly. And, you know, we play that fast, up-tempo, 20 guys every single night. And, you know, we got a lot of guys that come to work, and we need that every single night to be successful. And I think most of the time we get that, and that's what's made us successful so far.
And the fact, again, just going back to that night in October when you took the microphone, how long did you think about what you were going to say to the crowd that night?
I was trying to memorize it for probably 4 or 5 days when I found out I was going to do that. That's probably about the only thing that was going through my head for 4 or 5 days, is just any spare moment, just say it over and over until I, you know, knew it off by heart. And, you know, I'm not a big public speaker or anything, so I was pretty nervous doing that.
Yeah, well, you nailed it, to say the least. And I'm wondering how that has fueled this run that we have seen.
I definitely think the beginning of the season, 100%, you know, it brought us together, you know, quicker, I think, and brought us together with the community a lot quicker than, you know, if that didn't happen, which is horrible to say. But, you know, it got our team out in the community, trying to help in any way they could. And, you know, I think guys, as soon as that happened, were wanting to do as much as they could. And, you know, from the start in Dallas to the first home game, it wasn't, we weren't playing for points. We were playing for the city and the people that were affected by it. You know, just hearing after games how much 3 hours of the hockey game was helping people forget for a few hours what happened and kind of just try to get past it. You know, guys were really excited that they were doing that much just by playing a hockey game. So it became, you know, we wanted to win for the city.
Vegas Golden Knights defenseman Derek Englund, who also happens to be a nominee for the Mark Messier Leadership Award and also the King Clancy Memorial Trophy, for the player who best shows leadership qualities and gives back to the community, right here on the Rich Eisen Show. A couple more minutes here with Derek. What about your journey? You're a 36-year-old man who has Vegas roots for all those years, going back, as I mentioned, to the Las Vegas Wranglers. Before that, you played for the Lowell Lock Monsters, the Moose Jaw Warriors, the Wilkes-Barre Scranton Penguins, the Hershey Bears, so on and so forth. What does this journey mean for you, where you're currently standing, Derek, going into the Western Conference Finals here?
Oh, it's been an amazing journey. You know, you look back at those days of me and my wife driving across the country with our Yukon loaded right up. We couldn't even recline our seats. You know, driving across for 36 hours to get to the place we were going, and to do a full circle and be back here where it all started, playing in the NHL, it's been a dream come true, and I couldn't be any happier right now.
And the playoff beard right now, Derek, how deep is it right now? How thick is it?
I started a little bit before the playoffs.
So. Okay.
But I normally have a pretty big beard, so it's nice to have that back.
Okay. Okay. So do you use any products at all, or just let it go?
Yeah, I guess. We got some beard shampoo in the rink at the practice facility, and then... you know, you use the beard oils here and there when, you know, you're maybe going out for a dinner or something, like get some little bit of shine in it, you know?
Okay, class it up. Class it up a little bit.
Yeah.
I understand. And what shows have you seen there in Vegas? Or just, again, you're a local for years, right? So you don't do any of that? Tell me, how do you handle that, Derek?
Yeah, we still go to shows. We try to see as many as we can.
It's the last one.
We try to get in a couple every summer.
What's the last one you've seen?
Last one we went to, we took my son Cash to the Beatles Love Show.
Okay,
I believe that's the last one.
Okay,
it was great. But I've been to most of the Cirque du Soleil ones: Absinthe, Blue Man Group,
okay,
Terry Fader.
Terry,
I've been to quite a few.
Okay,
still some that you got to hit.
Okay, very good. Hey, Derek, again, just one last thing, just. What goes on in your locker room right now when you look at all these guys who you basically came together less than a year ago and have this opportunity? Do you voice it, or did you just look each other in the eyes and you all just have some sort of unwritten, unsaid language between the two, everybody?
I think we've done a good job all season of staying even keel, taking it one game at a time, and I think that's still our look coming into this round is, worry about game one, and after that, we'll worry about game two and just keep her going one game at a time.
And Marc-Andre Fleury, just give some voice about what he's meant, and obviously with the rings he already has on his hand.
Yeah, he's been phenomenal. He's on the ice, off the ice, everything. He's the backbone of our team, the face of the franchise. He, and then you get him in the locker room where, maybe people don't see, and he's just a great human being. He's one of the best guys I've ever met. Going back to Pittsburgh, I thought the same thing, and having him on your team, it's I think any team would welcome him onto their team with how he is off the ice and his play.
Derek, thanks for the time. Travel safe. Good luck moving on. And just speaking on behalf of, a guy who just talks sports for a living, turns on the TV for years and watches sports, your speech back in October is why we love sports and why we frequently look to sports stars, sports heroes, and look to folks like you to lead the way. And when we see somebody do it so eloquently and then back it up with what you guys have done all year, it's pretty awesome. So thank you.
Oh, thank you very much. That means a lot.
You bet. It's Derek Englund, Golden Knights defenseman, here on The Rich Eisen Show.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.